Hi, this is Anne for Graphic Design How To, and today I want to tell you about how to make a ribbon design, an arched ribbon design in Illustrator. So first off, I want to go over the key commands I'm going to be sharing with you. I'll say something like grab the M tool or grab your G tool or your V tool. And when I say that, I just mean press the letter M on your keyboard. So that will get you to the tool over here on the left, unless you're in a text box where it'll just type the letter M. So if that happens, just click out of the text box and then you can just type the letter M or T or whatever. That's not Control M or Shift M, it's just the letter M. So let's get started. First, grab your M tool. That is your rectangle. And then just click and drag a long rectangle like this. And I'm going to choose let's go with a green color over here. Now, with your V tool, option drag this, kind of like this. And then we'll move with your V tool, move this over like this. And we're making this part of the little ribbon right now. Now, go up to Object, Path, and Add Anchor Points. And what that does, if we zoom in here, you can see we've got, usually you'll have four anchor points, but when you add anchor points, it adds an anchor point halfway through or halfway between the anchor points that are existing. So now that we have that, let's switch to the A tool and then start drawing a rectangle out here like this, and select just that one point on the side there. Now use your arrow keys to move this in. You can also hold the shift key and arrow and it'll go a little faster. Okay, so let's do about like that. Then you can command minus to get back to where you were, or command zero. To get the hand tool, you can hold down the space bar and move the canvas around to wherever you want it. Okay, so let's change our color to be a little darker than this color. To do that, I'm going to click over here in swatches to add a color. And then you can hold option and command and pull these sliders over, and that will make a light or a dark tonal of that color. So if you're on a PC, you'll want to do control and option. Okay, so let's do it. Command, option, and drag a little bit. Just make it a little darker. Okay, and it's in the front right now, so hold shift, command, and left bracket to send to the back. You can also go to object, arrange, send to back here, and you can see the key command there. All right, now with the V tool, let's copy, paste in front. Whoa, that didn't work the way I thought it would. Okay, so if you need to, click off, click back on, copy, paste in front, and now you can see that there are two layers. I'm gonna undo that. So now hit your O tool and then hit return, and that will bring up this dialog box. You'll want it to be vertical and then say, okay. Paste in front was Command F or Control F on a PC. Now let's slide this over with your V tool, click and just drag, and you can hold shift to get it to stay on the same axis. Okay, so now we've got this part of our banner. Let's, with the V tool, select all three, draw a box around all three like this. And let's go to the Pathfinder. And some options aren't showing right, or I guess the align. Come down here to distribute spacing and go ahead and click show options if this isn't showing for you. Now click this second one, it'll distribute the spacing so they're all equal. Okay. Now we're gonna need to draw this little shape here. So get your P tool, then hit your P tool. You can also hit Shift Control A if you're on a PC. Okay, so let's zoom in a little here. That's Z and drawing a square. And then with the P tool, click here, 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 oops, and then close the shape. Click back on your first one. Okay, now this we want to fill with an even darker color. So let's add a new swatch. There we go. And hold Option and Command to make it a little bit darker. There we go. And still stay within that tonal range. Okay, so now get your V tool, click on that little shape, copy, paste in front with Command F or Control F, hit O, and then return, which will bring up the reflect dialog box. Vertical is what we want. Say okay. And then with your V tool, let's slide this over where it should go. Okay, so we've got most of our shape here. Let's get the V tool and select everything with a box around everything like this. Let's group these things. Command G or Control G on a PC. Now go to Effect, Warp, and I like Arc. Arch will keep this sides straight, but arc kind of turns them out, and I think it's a little more natural. So let's go with arc. And 24% is a good amount, so let's say okay. And now we have almost exactly what you see above. Okay, so to get our type on here, there's two ways to do it. You can just type on a straight line, group it with this shape, and then do the effect warp arc thing, and it will do it all together. But that kind of makes your type a little warped. If you don't want that, you'll want to make a copy of this, and that's what we're going to do in this tutorial. So hold Shift and Option and drag, actually start dragging and then hold Shift and Option to make a copy. And then let's go to Object, Expand Appearance. Okay, now we have some pieces here, and I want to use that piece to get that arch and make it really easy to type on that path. So grab your A tool, click off, grab your A tool, and just get on the very edge of this. Okay, so all of your little handles should be white right now. If you clicked on the edge, they'll be white. So copy, and then Shift Command A to clear, and then paste in front. Okay, so we've got a fill, and we don't want the fill over here. So you can either click this, or you can hit the question mark key to clear that out. Now, let's use our V tool to move this up a little bit, right here. And then grab your Type on a Path tool and just click right on there. Now this is going to be, this is going to cause a little bit of a problem. You're going to be typing upside down, but that is normal and we'll fix it here in a second. So let's type your title here to match the text above. Then click, you'll have to actually click the V tool this time. And then you can get on the little line there. And let's pull that all the way over here. Now there's a middle line, and we'll want to click on that and hold and drag it up. That'll put it right side up. Now let's go ahead and just center it. So you can go to Paragraph and Center, or you can do Shift Command C. Let's get our eyedropper tool with the I key and just click the title. And we're almost done. Now you can use your V tool to position it how you want. And that's it. That's the entire tutorial for today, how to make a ribbon. If you like this video, please click the like button. If you want to see more like this, please subscribe. And leave me a comment if you have any trouble. I would love to hear your problems and I'll try my best to answer them. And yeah, that's it. Thank you. This is Anne for Graphic Design How-To.